EcoFlow has been all gas and no brakes lately when it comes to releasing new power stations. Considering power stations are a technology that not everyone is familiar with yet and not everybody understands, you'd think EcoFlow would go in the direction of making it simpler and easier to understand, not more confusing and overwhelming. But they didn't. So today, that's what we're hoping to help you guys with, because at the end of the day, there's really only one EcoFlow unit that you should be spending your hard-earned money on. So welcome back to the lab where our opinions cannot be bought. We have made a ton of EcoFlow videos on the channel this year, and we get tons of questions from you guys asking which one is best for you. Now we do have a super easy quiz that we built. It's in the description of all of our videos. It takes like 30 seconds and gives you guys an instant recommendation. Otherwise, specifically talking about EcoFlow products, today we're gonna try to answer that question for you guys, because their product lineup has gotten out of hand. EcoFlow's been doing things this year like releasing the Delta 3 Max, which you think would be an evolution of the Delta 2 Max. But the Delta 2 Max is actually the better power station. You need to get the Delta 3 Max Plus to get on the same playing field as the Delta 2 Max. It's a show, and hopefully today we can help you guys navigate. EcoFlow's best and easiest to understand product lineup is their Delta Pro line. This is their top tier power station lineup. All of the products in the Delta Pro lineup have 240 volts, they have big batteries, big inverters, and there's tons of accessories that you can pair those products with. This lineup includes the original Delta Pro, the Delta Pro 3, the Delta Pro Ultra, and now the Delta Pro Ultra X. All these power stations get better and more expensive as you work your way up the product lineup. This is their only product lineup that actually makes sense. If you want a bigger battery or a bigger inverter or more features, you just go up the product lineup. It'll cost you a bit more money, but you get exactly what you're looking for. If only they were all like this. If you're wondering which Delta Pro in this lineup is the best one for you, unless you want to integrate full home backup with something like the Delta Pro Ultra, we think that the Delta Pro 3 is probably the best power station for the average person. It's a great value. It offers the ability to be moved around really easy with the suitcase handle and the wheels. You can scale your battery capacity by buying expansion batteries, and it just covers a wide variety of applications that we think the average person would probably be best suited for the Delta Pro 3. The only place the Delta Pro Ultra and X shine above that is, like I said, if you're trying to seamlessly integrate this as whole home backup, they're more permanent solutions. They're meant to be put a bunch of batteries underneath the inverter and you set it and forget it. If you're trying to move this around at all, take it with you anywhere, Delta Pro 3 is probably your best bet. So working our way down the lineup, EcoFlow's Delta series is where most of their products lie. These units offer 120 volts, have mid-size batteries and inverters, and some of them work with their accessories from their bigger power stations. This lineup includes the Delta 2 and the Delta 3. If only it was that easy. There's like sub lineups within those. This is where EcoFlow is really making a mess and it's getting very confusing. They keep adding derivatives to existing products instead of just calling them something new so that we can keep track of what's happening, or making like one better power station, like making the Delta 3 better than the Delta 2 instead of making six Delta 3s when there was only one Delta 2. This is where the real mess is. Currently with the Delta 2, you can get the Delta 2 or the Delta 2 Max. This was clearly before EcoFlow decided to start a fire. The Delta 2 Max is actually still one of our favorite EcoFlow products. It's still something that we recommend over a lot of the new Delta 3 products. Even though it's a couple years old, it still has a lot of standard features. It has two expansion battery ports, it has six grounded outlets on it, tons of USB options. It's got pretty fast solar charging. It's got a big battery, the big inverter, and it's just priced right. Like compared to some of the newer products, as this one gets a little older, it gets a little cheaper. It's a really, really good buy. When it comes to the Delta 3 lineup, you can get the Delta 3 Classic, the Delta 3, the Delta 3 Plus, and the Delta 3 Max. You can then get the Delta 3 Max Plus, you can get the Delta 3 Ultra, and the Delta 3 Ultra Plus, and as of very recently, you can get the Delta 3 1000 Air. So there's basically like three categories of Delta 3 within the Delta 3 lineup. They really should have done a better job at splitting these up. If we were in charge of it, here's how we would split them up. So First up, we would have the Delta 3 Ultra in its own lineup. This design is kind of what you expect when you think of a Delta Pro or a Delta Pro 3. It's got the wheels, it's got the suitcase handle, but it only offers 120 volts, not 240, and it has a smaller battery and a smaller inverter. So this lineup would be the Delta 3 Ultra and the Delta 3 Ultra Plus. Next, we would have just the Delta 3 lineup. This is a traditional style power station. It's smaller, still has a good amount of plugs and features, slightly smaller battery and inverters than you're gonna get on the Delta 3 Ultras. And as of very recently, we have the Delta 3 1000 Air. There's only one of these at this current time, but clearly they're gonna go in a new direction with this. Why this is called a Delta 3, I have no idea. I really don't. And with this, it looks like they're coming out with the Air 2000, and then they also have 10 millisecond options, so there's gonna be two of each for faster UPS. It's getting worse. If you're wondering which one you should get, we would recommend getting the Delta 3 Ultra Plus. It has the most features, functionality, and offers the best performance out of the two. The only reason we would recommend going down to just the Ultra is if you really need to fit it inside of your budget. If you can afford to go up to the Ultra Plus, it's 100% worth it in terms of value. It just makes sense. Looking at the Delta 3 category of just a traditional power station, no suitcase handle, no wheels, we would recommend that you guys go for the Delta 3 Max Plus. Same thing goes here. It has the biggest inverter, has the biggest battery, has the most features you can expand. You can plug it into expansion batteries. The app has the most features built into the app. It just makes sense. Like in terms of value, if you're gonna spend some money on a power station, buy that one and only go down if you really need to fit it inside of your budget. A lot of those Delta options are meant to just get people into power. Like if you're just new and you wanna get a cheap, affordable unit, you can go ahead and grab one. But a lot of the features and power come at that top end of the lineup. So we would recommend always just shooting for the top end of the line and only coming down if you really can't afford to spend that money. And working our way down the lineup some more, we got the River lineup. These are generally small, compact, very little power stations. They offer 120 volts, small inverters, and small batteries. This lineup includes the River 2 and the River 3. Again, these both break down into more products, but the same rules apply, slightly different derivatives. So you start with a product name. So you'll have the River 3, then you'll have the River 3 Pro, then you have the River 3 Plus, then you have the River 3 Max, and then you have the River 3 Max Plus. But it doesn't matter here at all, because if you guys are wondering what is the best River to buy, the answer is a Delta. If you take a look at something like the River 3 Plus, this has a 286 watt hour battery with a 600 watt inverter. It's got three 120 volt house plugs, two on the back, one on the front, and a couple USBs. That's it. Whereas something like the Delta 2 has a 1024 watt hour battery, which is 3.5 times bigger than this, and an 1800 watt inverter, which is 3 times bigger than this, which means you'll be able to run some actual appliances within your home from this. This can do a couple light things, but you're gonna end up surging it if you're trying to run regular household appliances. Point being, this power station with 620 volt house plugs right here on the back and the 3.5 and 3 times bigger specs, there's $100 difference between these. So if you're gonna spend $280 on this River, then just use our discount code and buy the Delta 2. You get a unit that is 3 times more powerful for $379. This is just a no-brainer. But if you're sold for some reason on the compact design and size of a River, and you really don't want to spend money on a Delta, we really favor the River 3 Plus wireless and the River 3 Plus if you don't need the wireless. Ours used to be wireless until someone connected it to their phone and went home with it, AKA tiny baby. This is still expandable. You can get expansion batteries for it. It does have a decent amount of plugs and features. The wireless charger that comes out and sticks to your phone is huge. Like, we really love a unit like this for what it is.
We like the light.
It does have a light. We just find it hard to justify value. If you're gonna spend about 300 bucks, spend another 100 and get something that can do way more than this can. That way in the future, when you decide this isn't enough, you already have something that is. EcoFlow also has a new trail lineup. They're basically just big battery banks that you would traditionally buy to like throw in a bag and keep your phone charged on a day trip or something like that. There's no AC plugs on this. It's just USBs. You can charge it with solar And if you get the bigger one, it does have a 12-volt car socket, but it's only DC power. There's no AC power on a unit like this. There's only two of these right now. There's the 200 and the 300. Thankfully, these ones follow simple logic, where the 300 is better than the 200. In our opinion, if you're looking to buy one, we would recommend you go 300, strictly because it has a 12-volt car socket, which makes it actually somewhat useful outside of just charging phones and laptops. You can also solar charge this, which is huge. If you're camping or something like that, run a solar panel into it, get some power into this. This one, you cannot do that. It's basically just a giant power bank. So EcoFlow, please make this easier for people to understand. People go on your website, and as soon as they get there, it's overwhelming. You click like Delta lineup, and you have a product page with tons of stuff. There's no logic on how to sort through it or what's better than the other thing. You guys really make a good product, but you confuse a lot of people, and it doesn't have to be this hard. Otherwise, that's pretty much all we got for you guys. Thank you so much for watching. We will catch you in the next one. Peace out and stay charged.